was just another church kid. I didn't do a lot of bad stuff. I didn't do a lot of great stuff. I just did what I did to fit in. I didn't see any teenagers around me that really lived for Jesus in a passionate way. So I wasn't really sure what that really looked like. I sort of just followed the leaders in our youth group, and I saw, well, this one's getting a girlfriend, so I'll get a girlfriend. This one's being funny and cutting up, so I'll be funny and cut up. I'll just do what everybody else is doing. And it led me to the same place that it led all of them. One of the lowest points in my life, the closest I came to turning it all in and ending my life was about age 20. And when I hit 21, it was probably the first time that I ever just opened up the Word and read for myself. It was the book of James. I attacked James first because I've told a lot of you guys before that I'm dyslexic. That's something I've always dealt with. And I thought, you know, James is two and a half pages long. I can handle James. And one of the very first things I saw was, consider it pure joy, my brothers, when you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. The day that I started having my own walk with Jesus, my own Jesus, everything started to explode. I want to see teenagers have their own everyday walking around friendship with God. I want to see adults who've been saved for years. I want to see this conceptual revival service, worship service moment. I want to see it start to become life. That happened for me, and that's happening for me. What I'm discovering about myself, and I feel might be happening with a lot of us, is a lot of our faith, our walk with Jesus, our juice that we have in our walk with God, a lot of it is borrowed from other people. I'm passionate when I'm with the youth group. I've got the youth group's Jesus on me. I've got my favorite artist's Jesus. I got the concert Jesus on me. I've got church and revival Jesus on me. Well, I can't have other people's Jesus. I've got to have my own Jesus, my own everyday walking around friendship with God. I don't think we really own what we believe. I don't think it's really ours personally until we can take it out and make words out of it and give it to someone else. Until you can pour your faith into another person, it's not yours. I've got to say that being an author is a little humorous to me. A dyslexic with a book, I'm trying to figure out how this is supposed to work. I talked with a new friend, Max Licato, recently and asked him how his books come together. And he said, they always start with sermons. They always start in the church. They start with what I'm doing here. And that's the way it works with me. I was speaking at a Christian school on a conference once, and one of the teachers was telling me that, he said, Mark, you got a tough crowd here. They've heard it all and they've seen it all. And what he said was, he said, you know, something happens when Jesus becomes your homework. And that just got into me. I couldn't get that out of my head. And one of the very first truths I hit them with that morning, and it stayed in me since then, is this: God is not a book. God is a person that walks with me, that knows me, that wants me to know Him. That is a friendship you can draw from. It's all because